Yo, what is up everybody? What's going on? DJ Kev here, back at it again with another video. Today there's going to be a little bit of tension in the room because today we're going to do a little bit of a head-to-head challenge. In today's DJing world, it seems like stick lighting is the trend for DJs. So in this video, we are going to put the Ape Lab sticks up against the Shave Freedom sticks. Let's get into it. So you guys know I like to be completely transparent, and I am not the guy to talk to you about specs, programming, troubleshooting. I am nowhere near an expert on any of these lights. I just want to talk about what's important to me when it comes to lighting. So as you guys know, I really only DJ part-time here and there. So because of that, price is always number one priority to me. If I DJed full-time, then I wouldn't be as worried about the price because I know the investment would pay off eventually. So as a part-time DJ, of course, you really got to make sure you make a return on your investment. So for these Ape Lab sticks, for about four of these, you can get them for $1,000. At the time, I only bought two, so it was around $700 for two of these. So that comes with the charger, the remote, and I was also supposed to get metal clamps for these, but those just never came in. On the other hand, the Shave Freedom sticks, you can get four for around $650. And that comes with chargers, the remote, four stands, and a carrying case. So for the Shave Freedom sticks, they really make it a whole package where you get all in one. You don't have to worry about a thing once you buy them. Now I know size matters to a few people, but hey, you know, the little ones need love too. The Ape Lab sticks give you about 2 feet worth of length, while the Shave Freedom sticks give you about 5 feet worth of length because they're really meant to stand on their own. Next, I'd like to get into how user-friendly each of these lighting sticks are. When it comes to the Ape Lab sticks, there is a nice little button at the top here that you can press down. And as you can see, it turns on. When I previously used these, I had them link up to sound. Nice and bright. However, this remote gave me such headaches because these buttons are just not as cut and dry as they should be. I feel like majority of the lighting that I've ever bought in the past just have buttons for what color you want. You click it, it turns on. However, when it comes to Ape Labs, there's a lot of guess and check when learning how to use this remote. Eventually, I figured out that you have to press this microphone in order to scroll through which color you want. But eventually, you figure it out. And what you figured out with the Ape Lab sticks, they are fairly user-friendly. Now, when it comes to the Shave Freedom sticks, you do have a little switch back here that you just flip on, and it just lights up the whole Freedom stick. Every button on this remote does exactly what it's supposed to. I watched one YouTube video on how to set each of these light sticks up, and they all do exactly what they're supposed to. So basically, once you figure out both of these lighting sticks, they are pretty easy to use. Now, when it comes to battery life, I will say both of these sticks were able to last about 5 hours, which is typically how long my events run. But I will say I do run these lights on auto mode. So if you do end up getting a receiver for both of these lights and you decide to use some lighting tricks or strobe lights, then the battery life may change. At this time, I really don't know. I just know they do run for 5 hours with no issues, same brightness at the events that I use them for. Now, when it comes to setup and travel, nothing gets easier than the Ape Lab sticks. I did have to buy a case for them, so I personally just bought a tripod carrying case and wrapped them up in bubble wrap. Once you use the remote to get the correct light that you want, you really just prop them up because these little circles back here are magnetic, which allows you to prop them up on a tripod or on the speaker stands or on your facade. Me personally, I have the RCF Evox J8s, so I just prop them up right on the speaker poles. And at the end of the night, you just press this top button again to turn them off, pack them up, and you're ready to go. Now with the Shave Freedom sticks, because they're meant to stand on their own, they do take a little bit longer to set up. The carrying case that comes with it is about 5 feet tall, so a bit of a hassle when carrying around. Of course, everything is all relative. They still are pretty convenient carrying around when compared to other lighting setups. And me personally, when I use these, I prop two on a stand and two other ones on a tripod to give it some sort of tower effect, which I really like when compared to just putting four straight on the ground. Now, when it comes to impact on how each of these lighting systems affect your setup, that's all really subjective. In my opinion, the Ape Lab sticks make much more of a difference on your setup because its light is just so bright. Even in the most well-lit areas, the Ape Lab sticks are able to show off how bright they are. Therefore, it looks even better in a darker room. As opposed to the Shave Freedom sticks, I really haven't been able able to use these lights at its full potential. My past few events that I brought this to, either I wasn't able to set them up directly behind me, or the events that I was at, the room was just too bright for anyone to really care about these lights behind me. So when it comes to versatility, I do have to give it to the Ape Lab sticks. You can really use them anywhere as long as you're able to prop them up. Although at the same time, if you aren't able to prop them up, if nothing is magnetic on your setup, then I guess the Freedom Sticks, being able to stand on their own, would technically make them a little more versatile. However, when it comes to function, they're not really able to make as much of an impact unless you're in a really dark room. The best part about setting up these lights is the fact that they are both battery powered, there's no wires, and if you set each of these sticks up to be the same light, then it makes it seem like they're working off of DMX. However, with the Ape Lab sticks, sometimes if you have it on sound mode, one color might go off and the other stick may not, so it might be a little bit of a back and forth. However, if you put these both on the same color, they usually work fairly well. As opposed to the setup with the Chauvet Freedom Sticks, once they're set up, they're usually good to go. For example, I labeled this specific one to be my transmitter, and I labeled the other ones to show which number receiver they are. And I made sure I set them up that way, so when they are in program mode, they follow the correct pattern that they should be in. Now, of course, it wouldn't be a true head-to-head without showing you guys a little bit of a demo of how each of these lighting systems work. So for that, I'm gonna bring you guys downstairs to my garage so we can check out how both of these work. Let's go. Alright guys, so welcome to the garage. Behind me I have my two RCF Evox J8s, and basically I'll show you guys what the setup is like for both the Ape Lab sticks and the Chauvet Freedom sticks. So I will set up both, and after that I'll show you guys a little bit of what they're capable of. So, let's get into it. Alright guys, so you're able to see a little bit of what the setup is like. They are both fairly easy to set up. Again, with the Freedom Sticks, you do have a little bit more to worry about because you got to make sure your ceilings are high enough to do the tower-like setup, such as I did behind me. And of course, for the Freedom Sticks, you also got to make sure the room is dark enough in order for it to impact your setup enough. But now that we are set up, I will power up one lighting system at a time. So first up, let's check out the Ape Lab Sticks. So I did want to make the room as dark as possible so you guys can get the full effect of exactly how impactful each lighting system is to your setup. So for the Ape Lab sticks, as you can tell, they are nice and bright. They stand out so much when it comes to being in front of my RCF Evox J8s. Now at this time, I do have them powered to sound, so that's why they're flashing every now and then. Now they aren't as sensitive as you would think, such as when I'm talking, they're not going off, but it does go off when the bass bumps. And honestly, I do think that that's better because otherwise it would go off for every little sound that goes off and they would basically be strobe lights. However, when there is bass, it really bumps. Sorry about talking in the dark. I just wanted to show you guys how impactful the lighting really is on the Ape Lab sticks. And I'll show you guys a little bit more of what the other colors are and the other color modes within the Ape Lab sticks that you can do. Guys, so you were able to see what colors the Ape Lab sticks were capable of. It could even go into a certain color mode where it switches between all these different colors. And for me, I do like to put these lights to sound to add a little touch of flavor during dance sets. However, it's time to move on to the Chauvet Freedom Sticks. Let me show you guys how these work. All right guys, so I don't know if you could see me, but I'm still gonna talk. As you can see, they're already pre-programmed into auto mode. I have them on this certain program. They think they have about 32 different auto programs you can use. The fact that they could be programmed wirelessly, battery powered, and all be DMX is something that really caught my eye, something that really sold me. However, in my opinion, they kind of look like Christmas lights. It reminds me of like going to an arcade and all those lights around each video game system. I really wish they had a white filter over the cover of these in order to not show off every single light dot in here. Now this room is completely dark and it is lighting up the room quite well. However, it is kind of rare for me to do an event where the room is as dark as it is now. Now I personally will probably always keep these in auto mode, so I will show you guys a little bit of the other programs you can set it to. Alright guys, so I was able to give you a little bit of a light show with the Charvet Freedom Sticks. Now maybe I'm a little bit biased because I'm not able to use these as often as I wish I could. However, I can't deny the fact that these do have some really cool effects. If you are able to get the room dark enough, then yes, these have some very, very cool effects that they are capable of. And I do love the fact that it is 360 lighting throughout the tube. But regardless of how many effects they have, if they can't be used in the right setting, then unfortunately, they're not as useful as they look. And for someone like me, it's a little bit hard to get past the arcade Christmassy looking lights. But to a normal person in the crowd, I bet these effects look really, really cool, and I can't deny that. So let me break all of this down, and let me meet you guys back upstairs for my honest opinion and final reviews. I'll catch you guys soon. So we're back. I want to close this video out with what my ratings would be of each of these products, starting with the Ape Lab sticks. Now when you tie in everything that we spoke about, such as the pricing, the versatility, the setup, the impact, I do have to give the Ape Lab sticks a 9 out of 10. I just love how bright these are, the fact that I could bring it to almost all of my events no matter how bright the room is. And while they are more expensive, they do feel a lot more durable when compared to the Charvet Freedom Sticks. And even with the remote giving me a headache, once I was able to figure out how that worked, setting these up really is a breeze. So I have to say I do love my Ape Lab Sticks. Now of course these aren't perfect. I would have loved if the Ape Lab Sticks had a program where the lights run up and down the tube, just like they do with the Charvet Freedom Sticks. And I know if it had 360 lighting throughout, it would impact my setup even more. However, I know that would impact the durability and the overall build quality wouldn't be as nice. Now with the Charvet Freedom Sticks, I do have to give them a 7 out of 10. I do love the fact that when you buy these, it comes with 4 Freedom Sticks, it comes with the whole case, 4 stands. I did make the decision to buy 2 extra tripod stands to make it look even better. But basically, once you buy these, you're all set. And while that's all nice and convenient, I really can't bring these to every single event that I go to. I have to tie in factors such as, how bright will this room be? Am I willing to take 2 trips to get this long bag out of my car? So I hate to knock down the Charvet Freedom Sticks, it's just that for me, I'm just not able to use these as much as I wish that I could. The value really is there when you get the Charvet Freedom Sticks, but maybe I just don't do enough events in dark rooms to appreciate this long stick. So with all being said and done, the Ape Lab Sticks have just done more for me with my personal setup. And as a disclaimer, both of these lighting systems are not meant to light up the dance floor. They are not dance floor lighting. They are just eye candy, something to make your setup pop a little bit more. So unfortunately, these are not convenient ways to light up your dance floor. So if you guys were able to gain anything from this video, please like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. Let me know in the comments below if you guys have experience with other stick lighting. Or if you have personal experience with either the Ape Labs or the Charvet Freedom Sticks, then let me know who you would have chosen in this head-to-head lighting competition. Anyways guys, also follow me on Instagram to see what else I'm up to in the DJ world. And follow me on Twitch so you guys can catch the next stream. As you know, my name is DJ Kev and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace.
You can't understand us, cause you're too soft. Tell the band bands, run them straight through the machinery. They came through with a stick, and you heard it.